Hello. These days, a lot of people get heart diseases, and for many of them, it turns fatal. Once upon a time, only 45-year-olds and 50-year-olds got heart diseases, but these days, even 30-year-olds are running the risk of getting heart disease. They attribute this to our fast lifestyle, erratic sleeping and eating habits. And once you do get heart disease, the treatment prescribed to you is major bypass surgery or angiosurgery. But instead of all these invasive procedures, there's a new kind of procedure which is non-invasive and at half the cost, and is supposed to be free of all kinds of risks. This is being done at Oxymed Hospitals at Nandalam in Chennai. Let's find out what this treatment is. Hello, doctor.
Hello.
What are the various types of heart diseases that you treat here?
Well, we take care of most of the disease post-CABG cases. That is, after the bypass surgery, the surgery has failed and the patient has to go one more time surgery. Such patients we are treating without surgery. And ischemic heart disease, IHD what we call. That means the sufficient quantity of blood is not reaching the myocardium. So for those patients we are treating without surgery. And then dilated cardiomyopathy. So with low ejection fraction, that means the left side of the heart gets dilated, it gets enlarged, and then the heart is not able to pump out the blood. From this, various complication can come to entire vascular system. There is, the pedal edema, the water retention takes place, the patient is not able to breathe, and we can also call this as CHF, congestive heart failure. So when the heart is not able to pump enough quantity of the blood to the vascular system, so it can fail to receive the oxygenated blood to any part of the body. So from this, people can get other kinds of complication. Such disease, there is only donor heart they are always looking for heart transplantation. Here, without surgery, we are able to, restore the heart. It's pumping and it's functioning, and without surgery we are successful in treating such critical patients.
So other than conventional methods of diagnosis, that is like, you know, the angio and the CT scan, do you use other diagnostic methods?
Well, these conventional scans like angiogram and CT angio 64 slice, there is a particular dye called transluminal percutaneous dye. So they send the invasive, it's an invasive procedure. They send the catheter inside and then they allow almost 60 to 80 ml of dye. This dye can only penetrate on the bigger vessels. That's the main coronary arteries. So, which also has to come out through kidney and out. So, sometimes there is also a complications. So, we avoid this invasive procedure. We use angiocartogram, three-dimensional cartography. It's works on the principle of sound, pressure, volume and time. The sound waves can even go to the microvascular regions, even in almost about 5 to 10% of the block also it can be easily detected. So without any admission or taking to the theater, in 5-10 minutes we are able to successfully get the color image of the heart.
What are the various types of treatments and therapies that you use here?
Well, it is not just one treatment. It is a comprehensive, a holistic approach. Once the patient comes, we try to understand what all the problems of the patients, his sugar level, his cholesterol level, his renal impairment. And then based on that, we design a protocol. So foremost is basically in order to the results to last longer, we give the awareness, that is the education level. So lifestyle modification is being offered. So our nutrition and dietitian will give the, heart-friendly diet, renal-friendly diet. And then besides, also certain therapies are being given. Apart from this medication and counseling, therapies like ACT. ACT means arterial clearance therapy. So through the intravenous IV method, we administrate amino acids. These amino acids go inside the, not only to the heart. Who says there is a block only in the heart? The entire body, there is a different places there can be blockages. So when we address the vascular system, these amino acids goes inside and dissolves the blockages wherever it is and also softens the endothelium lining. So apart from that, we also give the ozone therapy. So ozone is a natural gas, which is, I mean, what we you and inhale is O2. Another atom attached is called O3. So the O3 is also being administered through the IV line mixed along with the NS solution. Apart from that, we also give EECP, Enhanced External Counter Pulsational Therapy. This counter pulsational therapy and ACT, ozone, lifestyle modification. So any kind of, I mean, most of the heart diseases we are able to tackle without surgery.
So you explained about the ACT and the EECP. Can you explain about them in little more detail?
Well, EECP is a kind of a passive exercise where for 1 hour it is given for every day. The US protocol is to be given for 35 days. So ECG monitoring is being done. So there is inflation and deflation. A special pant is given where like a blood pressure cuffs. So it is also, I mean, in the lower limbs, so the pants is being attached where the cuffs are inflating during the diastole period and deflating during the systole period. So in order to explain, see, the heart has got two modes, systole. During that time, the heart squeezes and pressurizes and allows the blood to go to the lower limb to entire vascular system. When it relaxes, that's what we call diastole. The venous return, what we call, entire blood is being returned back to the heart. During that time, so pre-systolic phase, during the diastole phase, the heart, the EECP, through the help of cuffs, it pushes the blood back into the myocardium. So what happens is the entire vascular system, there are millions of, I mean, we have the vascular system, microvascular regions. All these dormant vessels open up, and also the main vessels also opens up. And then with this, the block is able to, I mean, be cleared easily.
Okay, so what are the side effects of these treatments? Like you said, you're using extra pressure to pump the blood back into the heart. So are there any kind of side effects for these treatments?
Well, it is a scientifically approved therapy. 50 years of research has gone into that, and they have done pre and post angiogram after the EECP, and so they have given the FDA clearance that with the help of EECP, even in angiogram, they showed that the main arteries dilate and then the blockages are all eliminated. So it's a safe treatment, and the patients are able to comfortably take this treatment. It's a 1 hour treatment every day they come. Age group of about 25 year old, even up to 91 year old people are able to take. But if you see the older people, they have already undergone a bypass surgery. There is a high risk factor where their interventional cardiologist, they have suggested to go in for one more time surgery with the punchline that during the procedure, there's a 50-50 chances of death. So such patients, they do not want to take any risk. So it's a risk-free and completely safe treatment. Patients are able to well tolerate this treatment.
So how much does it cost to take this treatment as compared to the bypass and other conventional methods of treatment?
Bypass surgery, it's in India generally, they say, depending upon what facilities, rooms you take, if you take the lowest bottom in a general ward, they say a package of about 2-2.5 lakh rupees. But even then, if some complication comes that they have to stay in the ICU and things like that, it might run into maybe 4 lakhs or maybe more. But here, it is almost in an average 1,20,000 to 1,35,000. It does not exceed more than that.
So you say that this takes about 35 days. So an average on a day when a patient comes in, what kind of procedures does he undergo?
Well, normally when the patient come to all of them, we have a set protocol. First, as the patient comes, so the duty doctor, they go through the all past record, past history of the patient, whether the patient has undergone already a bypass surgery and whether the patient is hypertensive or whether the patient is diabetic, what all the types of medications already the patient has been prescribed. So we get the proper understanding. Then the duty doctor takes the weight, the duty doctor takes also the blood pressure, and then the cardiologist, they go through the ECG, and then they go through the echo, and then we come to an understanding about the patient. We also have our non-invasive diagnosis. As we do all that, as we enroll the patients and put into a routine program, the patient has to see a dietitian. We have MSc nutrition dietitian, where if they are having renal impairment, so they give, I mean, according to a diet, if they are diabetic, accordingly the diet is being suggested. Then, as the treatment starts, as a protocol, every day during the procedure, 1 hour of ECG is being recorded. So every beat of the heart is being noted. Apart from that, before starting the treatment, they take the BP, heart rate, and there's also pulse oximeter. Through that, we are able to monitor the oxygen saturation level, heart rate. So all these, every day the weight is being checked in order to, I mean, find out if there is any pedal edema, there is a fluid retention. So all these safety parameters are necessary as a protocol to monitor in a daily basis the patients. So before starting the treatment, we do the lipid profile to find out what is the cholesterol level, and then we do the sugar test. And during about 2-3 weeks of time, again we repeat those blood tests to see the before and after during the process of treatment, so that the medications can be changed from time to time. So overall, we have a pulmonologist, we have diabetologist, we have a DM cardiologist in our institution. They all are, I mean, monitoring from time to time in order to offer a simple treatment to the patients without surgery.
So we talked about a lot of heart diseases, but what are the ways to prevent these heart diseases from happening in the first place?
Well, what you're talking about, the prevention. General thing is, we all know about the lifestyle modification. Due to this stress factor, we are not able to focus on that. So these punchlines are to be repeated again and again so that we can draw the attention. Foremost is the stress management, and basically also food management. Food management, in sense, we have to have a heart-friendly food. Heart-friendly food in the sense is heart sodium-rich food is not, I mean, friendly to the heart. And oil-rich food are not friendly to the heart. And lack of exercise, dormant lifestyle, this is also not good for the heart. So all these combinations of exercise, proper diet, meditation, and then timely diagnosis, so one can prevent heart disease at a much early stage.
Thank you.
Welcome.
So this treatment that is non-invasive, non-surgical, pain-free, and also relatively of low cost is a great thing for heart patients, isn't it? Now let's go and talk to patients who have undergone this kind of therapy and see what they have to say.
One artery has blocked 99%, and another artery has blocked 75%, another artery has blocked for 80%. So then what happened, we told him that one of our friends has told that without any bypass surgery or any blood loss or anything, without any trouble, there is one hospital, it is called Oxymed Hospital in Nandanam. So my friends showed me this hospital. Then I came along with my family to this Oxymed Hospital, and then what happened, sir, there we have tested, I met Dr. Ayaz Akbar, and Dr. Ayaz Akbar told me to just, you have bring all your reports. Then I went home and I brought all the reports what I have tested, and then doctor told me that you have to go for this EECP, and after the EECP you have to go for this first ozone treatment. After taking ozone for 5 days, I have to go for this chelation, that is called chelation, for two and a half hours. So I went for that also. And EECP was for daily 1 hour. I have taken this treatment before 1.5 years ago. Now I feel much better and the symptoms are good. I don't feel any breathing problem. I don't feel any walking problem. I can walk fast also.
We have seen how even serious heart diseases can be treated by easy, non-invasive methods, as Dr. Ayaz Akbar and all the patients who have undergone the treatment just told us. If you need more information about these treatments, please contact Oxymed Hospitals in Chennai. But remember, prevention is always better than cure. So lead a healthy and balanced lifestyle and avoid the risk of heart disease.